Okay, so I did a little bit of prep work here, just to kind of get things going. I have two pieces of chipboard here that are cut to 8.5 by 6, so front and back. Then I also cut some colonial white cardstock to 8.5 by 6 as well. And then these little blue pieces here, this is some dotted, it's kind of like embossed dotted paper. I got this from Michaels, couldn't tell you, it didn't say like a brand name or anything on it. And it is cut to 2.5 by 6. And I also have this Disney comic strip paper. Now, I have no idea where I got this. I got this from the scrapbooking store when it closed out. I don't have like a name brand or anything like that, but I thought it was really kind of cool. So this strip is 1 7/8 by 12 inches long, of course. Now, because now best way is if I show you this, because if I have these two pieces of paper and I put them side by side, and because I'm going diagonally, like I'm going roughly about like this, now it's not gonna, the corners aren't gonna match up, so I had to do this extra little piece. And oh, and this black piece here, this is just black cardstock and it was cut to 2 inches, so it just left a nice little thin black border, 1/8 of an inch on both sides. So it's, or I guess it's smaller than 1/8 of an inch, but anyway, you get the idea. It's just a little thin black border on each side. So then what I'll do is, once I have everything all set up, is I'll, on the back side, because the back side doesn't matter as much as on the front side, is I'll make this, you know, on a nice angle, and I'll cut it off a little bit over this. And then I'll take this piece and I'll add a little bit on, and then I'll match up the corn, like match it up over here, just to give the, so that it matches up. If that makes sense. Okay, so that'll, we'll do that. And also, where's my little sheet? Now, I cut this out. This is the Disney, it's the word Disney. And I cut it all out. I'll show you out of, this is what it looked like when I cut it out. This is at 2 inches and this is at 1.5. So I cut it at 1.5 inches. And that's using, this is the Cricut Cartridge Disney Mickey font. And it's just that little little symbol right there. Alright, so let's start putting this together. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the 8.5 by 6 colonial white cardstock, and we're going to just kind of like enhance the edges on it. This is Tim Holtz's frayed burlap distress ink.
Arrogant like, yeah. Top like money, so the girls just mail. One too many, y'all know me like 12. Look like cash and they all just there. Bottles, models, better no chairs. Fall out, cause that's the business. All out is so ridiculous. Zone out, so much attention. Scream out, I'm in the building and they're watching, I know this. I'm rocking, I'm rolling, I'm holding. I know it, you know it.
You know I know how to make them stop and stare as I zone out. Can't even handle me right now. Watching you, watching me, I go.
make me pull. Came to party till I can't no more. Celebrate cause that's all I know. Tip the group, you're taking off they clothes. Grand finale like Super Bowl. Go hard, I run the show. That's right, while I've got money to blow. More lights, more ice when I walk in the door. No hype, do it big all over the globe. Yeah, I said it, don't tell it. Confetti, who ready? I'm ready, you ready? Let's get it.
No, I know how to make them stop and stare as I fall now.
For doing our inside pages, we're going to use, this is the Dream Cuts, and if you've never used one, it is really excellent for making your own books and stuff like that. So you just slide one sheet in at a time. This one in the back here, you can adjust it to do, it'll do a cut a page perfectly in half, so all you do is you just line it up. Because we're doing a 12 by 12, we stick it in the back here on the full thing, and I'm doing this with one hand, so it's pretty hard. I'm going to have to set the camera down for just 1 second. Okay, so I have it started. So then all you do is you just crank the handle, and it cuts it in half, just like that, and they all match up exactly, so all your pages are exactly the same. Okay, so our next step is to take our pages that we printed out and we're going to score them. So take your paper trimmer out, put your scoring blade in, put it to 8.5. Give it a couple of good scores. Just kind of pre-fold it. Make sure everything all lines up. Doesn't hurt to get your bone folder out. Give it a couple good swipes. Get your adhesive out. And then, get this out of the way, and just line up the edges. And there you have that side. Okay, that part's done. Okay, so this is what the book looks like with everything all together without the binding rings. So then what we need to do is you put your binding rings in. There's a trick to it so that you don't have the binding rings all sticking out. Like this would be sticking out, and if somebody ever caught their finger on it, not that it would hurt, it would be unpleasant. So what you do is put your book like how you would have it. Take your front page, flip it to the back, and then put your binding rings through. So I'll put that one there. Stay. Okay. And then put this one through. And put my binder in here. Okay. And then what you do is you set your binder or your binding machine for the size of the rings that you have. Mine are 1.25. I have it set in there. I'm going to give it a squeeze so it won't go anymore. Flip it around. Make sure everything's all laying flat. And then, oops, get back in there. Okay, and then give it another squeeze. Okay, so when I open it up, I just had a little bit of a malfunction. I think I'm going to replace those binding rings because I got them bent. But when you open it up, it'll flip open and then you'll have all your coils bound on the inside. So it'll be a nice, fresh coil. The reason why I picked the bigger coils, and that's probably why they bent, is because once it gets full, it's going to be really hard to get everything all in place. I use the smaller binding rings, and I think I'm gonna have to take mine out and put the bigger ones in later. So I just thought I would just save her the trouble and just do it right away because I don't think she has the equipment to do it. So that's the reason why I went that way. And then the only thing we have left to do is put the word Orlando on here. And these are Making Memory Tiny Alphas, white on black.